Player 2 has joined the game.
Hey, yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another two-player co-op quick hits edition. As always, I'm one of your hosts here, Kevin, along with my brother from my mother, Sean.
How we doing?
Pretty good. What are we talking about today, Sean?
We are going to look back at the history of, not all of, but some of the bigger launch titles.
Yeah.
Our hypothesis is that Breath of the Wild is probably the best launch title ever. So we're going to do a little deep dive and see if we can convince ourselves of not that.
When I think of it off the top of my head, there's only two or three other games that pop up. There might be something I'm forgetting. I haven't really looked at this list, so we kind of want to just go through it on the air, talk through it, and see what our thoughts are.
Yep.
And again, like Sean said, we're not going to go through every console.
No. But we don't need to know what launch titles were for the Master System or...
It's on this list. I did see Game that, Gear. But I don't... Yeah. Atari 2600.
Oh, we're going way back. We're in the Wayback Machine.
Blackjack? I think we played Blackjack on the Atari.
Like Blackjack? Like cards?
Mm-hmm. Or I remember it on the Intellivision. I don't remember which it is.
I don't remember it on either.
Indy 500. Yes.
Okay.
Or am I thinking of Pole... No, I'm thinking of Pole Position. Never mind. Starship, Street Racer, Surround, Video Olympics. Nope. Now, this one's important to us. Intellivision, 1979.
Before we were born. It's very important to us.
Backgammon. I do remember Dad had that. He had real backgammon.
I remember that.
And he had that.
I never knew how to play that game.
Armor Battle.
I don't remember that game.
ColecoVision, I'm not even talking about. Atari 5200. Okay. First, I mean, okay. Pac-Man. Galaxian. No. Space Invaders. Great game. Super Breakout. I don't remember what Breakout is. Is that like a brick breaker game like you used to have on the Blackberries? Yeah. Pac-Man's the first one.
So those are at least iconic.
It's at least in the conversation.
Yeah.
All right, Nintendo Entertainment System. And of course, we are American. We have freedom. I'm just joking. I mean, we do, but we're just going to focus on the U.S. releases because otherwise it's too confusing. U.S. launch of the Nintendo Entertainment System. This is awesome.
Awesome.
You're going to get hit with a fistful of nostalgia.
I'm ready for it.
10-yard fight.
Oh, the diagonal football game.
Diagonal? No, that was play action. 10-yard fight was up and down.
Oh, I do. Oh, that's a good game too, though.
Baseball. NES baseball. You remember
that? Did we have that?
Yes. That was one with the big fat bats. You'd be like, you could just have your bat here.
Oh, yeah.
Finish. Duck Hunt.
Yeah.
Excitebike.
These were all launch titles?
Golf.
Golf was awesome.
One of my favorite golf games ever made, for sure. Ice Climber, no. Kung Fu. I didn't realize that was a launch title. Maybe. Pinball. Shout out to Kate and Karen.
Yep.
That we Wheel of Fortune and Pinball.
We played the
We would go down there to
games.
Play those games just like it's nobody's business. Super Mario Brothers. That's the king right now.
So far,
write that
down.
Write down Super Mario and Pac-Man. I don't think the others even count. Do you want to know what the launch games were for the Master System? June of 86. I didn't realize. I thought it was a couple years after the NES. Hang On and Safari Hunt.
Okay.
Hang On. You know the motorcycle racing game.
Oh, that. Yeah. Okay.
Atari 7800. Now you're talking some classics here. Asteroids. Centipede. Dig Dug. Galaga. Mrs. Pac-Man, which everybody says is the superior Pac-Man.
Ms. Pac-Man.
Excuse me. Sorry. I'm not Colin Moriarty. She's Ms. Pac-Man. Pole Position 2.
2?
Xevious.
Hmm. Wait, but is this what we played Gauntlet on?
Yes.
You're telling me the same system that had Gauntlet also just had Centipede and Asteroid?
I'm sure, like, HD remasters.
I mean...
Or something.
I mean, I don't remember Gauntlet being, like, super, you know, high-res graphics.
No, it wasn't, but it compared was super to, like, fun.
Right, but I remember looking a lot better than, like, Centipede and Asteroid, but, wow, okay.
So is there any games there we should include in the discussion?
It's tough. I mean, none that are...
I don't get why everybody likes Ms. Pac-Man better than Pac-Man.
I don't even know enough to know, I don't know the difference.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know what the difference is.
There are some that could be in the conversation, but when you've already got Mario on the list, you already know none of these are going to beat Mario. Right. So
that's true.
I think we need to, yeah.
This one's funny to look at. TurboGrafx-16.
Bonk.
No.
No? Well, then I don't know.
Actually, I don't know any of these games. R-Type.
Yeah.
That's really it.
All right.
TurboGrafx-CD launched.
And you know that was a thing.
Fighting Street. You know what that is? Street Fighter 1.
That's what they called it?
They called it Fighting Street. It was like, it was called Street Fighter. I think maybe it's called Fighting Street in Japan or something, and then that's the name that they used for the TurboGrafx version or something.
Wow.
All right, here we go. Genesis.
Okay.
Altered Beast.
Yep.
And that's about it.
Oh, that's
because Sonic didn't come out for 2 more years. Tommy Lasorda Baseball. That was a really good baseball game, actually.
Did we play that?
Yeah. Rented it. Didn't own it. It was one of the black with the, you know, the grids and stuff.
Right.
One of those games. Hmm. Sega CD. Chuck Rock.
Oh, God.
In Excess, Make My Video. Marky Mark, Make My Video.
Oh, my gosh.
Night Trap. That was the launch game. Sega Classics 4-in-1. Let me see what that included. Sewer Shark. And Sherlock Holmes. So that came with Streets of Rage, Revenge of Shinobi, Columns, and Golden Axe. That's a heck of a collection, actually. From back then.
Yeah.
So none of those games make the cut, for sure. 32X. Doom and Star Wars Arcade. That's actually a good launch. That's it's only two games, but there's two.
The two of the best 32X games.
The only thing that annoyed me to this day about the Doom 32X version is the same as Super Nintendo. It had that bricks around the actual...
Oh, yeah.
I don't know why. The 32X should have been powerful enough to run Doom, for crying out loud.
Right. Star Wars, I always think of...
It's a trap.
It's a trap. And R2-D2 is... That was a good game, though.
Mm-hmm. I think of it more as an arcade game. I don't know that...
Yeah.
Do we play it? I'm sure we rented it on the 32X.
We owned it.
Did we? I'm sorry, that was too funny. Not to do. I don't know why they listed 32X before this, but Super Nintendo, best console ever made, we still say. It just came out of nowhere. Was that why? All right, so this one you need to take notes.
Okay, I'm ready.
U.S. launch of the Super Nintendo. You don't need to take notes on all these, but this was a hell of a launch. Like, this was one of the best launch lineups ever. I think we can agree when I say this. F-Zero, Gradius 3, Pilot Wings, SimCity was a launch game, and Mario World. I didn't realize SimCity was a launch game. That's my favorite version of SimCity, by the way, and I've played many of them. SimCity 2000 is probably my second favorite on the PC. Super Mario World is better than Super Mario Brothers.
Yes.
So as of now, that is the king of launch titles. Would you agree?
Yes.
Best console ever made. It the best lineup of games on any console ever. It's just there's I don't think you can really argue.
Yeah, that's the best.
You're the best.
Neo Geo AES. Is that just a Neo Geo? That's what I wonder.
I think.
Nope, nothing worth talking about. Okay. Philips CDI. Zelda was not a launch title, so that's funny.
That never happened, so that's why.
3DO. You could get one game at launch. People say the Switch only has one game. This really only had one game. Take a guess at what it was. Try to think back to the 3DO. And no, it's not Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo.
3DO. God. Was it a fighting game?
Nope.
Was it like, what's that game with like King Kong? And
nope, it wasn't Rampage.
Rampage.
It was a racing game.
Oh.
Crash and Burn.
Crash and Burn.
Burn. Poor shake. Beans. Poor 3DO. The only thing that
had 3DO, like, or am I thinking of something else? Was 3DO the one that was like $700? Like
it was $700, yes.
That's God.
Back then it was $700. Right. So it means it'd be like $1,100 now or something, yeah.
God. Who made 3DO?
Multiple. There, I think it was Panasonic. But, I think it was Panasonic.
That's right, yeah. Because it was Philips CDI, Panasonic.
Yeah, Panasonic 3DO. And it only had 3-button controller, but then they ended up putting Super Turbo on there. And they never put out a 6-button controller. God. They put out that game to die. We wanted that on our PC. We never got it, though, I don't think. I remember looking at it so many times at Babbage's or whatever it was at that time. Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo. We never got it, though. Because I don't think our PC was good enough to run it.
Super Street Fighter 2. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. But we had Super Street Fighter 2 on Genesis.
Yes.
But not Turbo.
Speaking of the Genesis, we're up to the Sega Saturn. This Panzer is actually Dragoon. This is actually a darn... This system gets such a bad rap. I know we are both Sega fanboys. This was a good system. I'm not saying it was as good as the PlayStation,
yeah.
But it didn't deserve... I mean, they launched it horribly.
Yeah.
But it should not have... You know, been their death spiral.
Panzer Dragoon?
Yes.
Virtua Fighter?
Yes.
Was like Nights into Dreams then, or did that come later?
No, that was like 98.
Okay. Then those are the only two I know.
Clockwork Knight?
Oh, yeah. Daytona.
Daytona.
And,
You're not going to. That's it.
Okay.
Pebble Beach Golf.
Yeah.
And Worldwide Soccer. Sega International Victory Coast Edition. Victory Goal Edition.
That's not a bad...
Clockwork Knight, Daytona, Panzer Dragoon, and Virtua Fighter. That's a damn good launch lineup.
I mean, at the time. Right. I mean, things obviously didn't pan out, but... Yeah, that's pretty good.
Super Mario World still king, correct?
Yes.
PlayStation Uno. U.S. launch. They had a lot of games. Not a lot, but this is another good launch lineup. Battle Arena, Toshinden. Great fighting game. I want to know who owns the rights to that, because I think it'll come back. ESPN Extreme Games, Kill Leak, the DNA Imperative, NBA Jam Tournament Edition, the Raiden Project, I don't know. Rayman.
Mm.
Ridge Racer.
Mm.
Street Fighter the Movie.
The game.
Not going to talk about that. Total Eclipse Turbo. I don't even know what that is. Pretty solid lineup. Battle Arena Toshinden. I played the stuff out of that at Tom's house. Tom Johnston's house. Shout out to Tom if you're watching.
I never got into any of those like 3D.
I liked fighters. That way more than I liked like Soul Calibur or anything like that. Yeah. Virtua Fighter 2 to me was always king. Virtua Fighter 4 once I got a PS2, but.
You're fine.
It's fine. Nintendo 64.
Oh, boy.
Two games. Do you remember what they are?
Mario?
Yes.
Cruisin' USA?
No.
Crap.
Another Super Nintendo launch game.
F-Zero?
Nope.
I don't remember what else there were.
Pilot Wings.
Oh, God.
So, I completely defer to you here. Mario World versus Mario 64. To me, Mario World is definitely the better game.
Yeah. Mario 64 was awesome. And it started basically a new genre. Yeah, I think Mario World's still better. Mario World.
Okay. I think so too, but I think Mario 64 doesn't hold up anywhere near as well today as Mario World does.
Correct.
Mario World is still, it's perfect.
Correct.
So Mario World is still king. Can anything from the Atari Jaguar knock it off its perch? No. Cybermorph and Trevor McFur in the Crescent Galaxy.
Okay. Wow.
The Jaguar CD launched with Blue Lightning, Mist. And no, that's it. Mist was so good. Although, I mean, I think that I bought it when I didn't have a Vita. I bought random games. once I got my Vita, I downloaded that, turned on, and I was like, this sucks. Nope, I don't want to play this
game. That game creeped me out for some reason.
I think if I was playing on a big screen with a mouse and I could, like, I think it'd be different than playing it on a Vita.
The two, the people, like in the red book and the blue book.
I didn't even get that.
When you get
far.
The Kate, yeah. When you get the pages and like their yep. video comes less and less staticky. Those video, they just creeped me out for some reason. A lot of things creeped me out back then, and I don't.
You
know
were
why.
A wuss. Yeah.
I guess so.
Sega Dreamcast had a F ton of games. Okay. Aero Wings, Air Force Deltra, Blue Stinger, Kart Flag to Flag, Expendable, The House of the Dead 2, Hydro Thunder. It's like you would just take two words, like
right.
a noun and adjective, and, or two nouns, really, and just go to Monaco Grand Prix, Mortal Kombat Gold. Now, was that like Ultimate Mortal Kombat
I've
3
never heard of it.
Trilogy Edition, whatever? I don't know.
Yeah, I would assume it was basically
Let's
Trilogy,
see what it
but.
Is. Oh, it's Mortal Kombat 4. Okay.
Oh, ugh.
That's horrible. NFL 2K, one of the best football games ever made. NFL Blitz 2000. Pen. Trill Celon. TRILCELON. Power Stone. People love Power Stone to this day. Ready to Rumble Boxing. I know you remember that.
Yep.
Sonic Adventure. Soul Calibur. Tokyo Extreme Racer and Trick Style. Lots of games doesn't mean that that's
not,
a great
not
bunch.
A, yeah, yeah. Not a lot of good ones in there.
PlayStation 2. A lot of people, I will say, my controversial gaming opinion, the PlayStation 2 is completely overrated. Now, it had Metal Gear Solid 2, Metal Gear Solid 3,
had
God
a lot
of War
of good
1,
games,
God of War 2.
But it just had a lot of games.
Yeah.
It seemed like there was more quantity over quality. But there were some good games.
So the U.S. launch had Armored Core 2, DOA 2 Hardcore, Dynasty Warriors 2, ESPN Track and Field, and Winter Games Snowboarding. I'm not even going to talk about those. Eternal Ring, Evergrace, Phantom Vision, Don't You Wanna? Gun Griffin Blaze, Madden 2001, Midnight Club, NHL 2001, Ready to Rumble, Round 2, Ridge Racer 5, Silent Scope, Smuggler's Run, SSX. Great game. Street Fighter EX 3. Wow, okay. Tekken Tag Tournament, Time Splitters, Unreal Tournament, and that's basically it.
So Ridge Racer was a launch for PlayStation, and they were up to Ridge Racer 5 by PlayStation 2.
By the way, I always get Time Splitters confused with Time Killers. Wasn't that the super violent fighting game? Do you remember Time Killers?
That must have been Time Killers, because it wasn't Time Splitters.
No, it wasn't Time Splitters.
But no, I don't remember Time Killers.
Oh, you don't?
Is this like an arcade game?
Yeah, and it was ported to home consoles. It might have been ported to 16-bit consoles, I think.
Hmm.
All right, GameCube. All-Star Baseball 2002, Batman Vengeance, Crazy Taxi. There you go. Dave Mira Freestyle 2, Disney's Tarzan Untamed. He's not just Tarzan. He's untamed. Luigi's Mansion. Madden 02, NHL Hits with a Z, 20-02. They couldn't just write 2002. They were so edgy, they had to write 20-02. Rogue Squadron 2, Super Monkey Ball, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 3, and Wave Race Blue Storm. Luigi's Mansion. Talk to me about Luigi's Mansion.
Never played it.
Oh, okay. Don't talk to
me. Never appealed to me, though.
A Mario game should just be a Mario game. I don't like gimmicks. Just give me right, a Mario yeah. or Luigi game.
You're Luigi and you're in a haunted house and you have to soak up ghosts with a vacuum cleaner. Like, what? Yeah.
I'm going to die. Xbox. Lots of games. I'm not going to go through all these because this is taking too long. Dead or Alive 3. Halo. Write Halo down. NASCAR. They had two NASCAR games at launch. Oddworld, Munch's Odyssey, Project Gotham Racing.
Munch's?
M-U-N-C, like Munch possessive.
Right, but not it's not Abe?
No, it's Munch's Odyssey.
Why is it C?
O-D-D-Y-S-E-E. Odyssey. And Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2X. Okay, I think that's the first one. More than Mario 64. I don't think it's better at all. It's the first one that
you could make on the level argument of
Mario World. Yes. Yeah. All right. Xbox 360. Amped 3, Call of Duty 2, Condemned. That was a messed up game. Wasn't Condemned, or I'm thinking of Manhunt. Condemned was a Stone Cold Steve Austin movie.
It was, but I don't think that's what this is.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I was thinking. It was messed up. Manhunt was just one of the worst games ever.
I remember that.
Most violent.
Yeah,
yeah. FIFA, Madden, NBA. Need for Speed Most Wanted. Probably the best Need for Speed game from what I remember. Perfect Dark Zero. Did you ever play Perfect Dark Zero?
No. But I had Perfect Dark.
On the N64?
Yeah.
Project Gotham Racing 3, Quake 4, Ridge Racer 6. So it took them all the way until then to get to 6. Tony Hawk's American Wasteland. I think a lot of people loved American Wasteland.
Really?
I tried playing those games like in college with all my idiot high roommates. And I was like,
I played one of them. I don't remember which one, but I didn't care for it.
There was also Peter Jackson's King Kong, the official game of the movie. Mark that one down. PlayStation 3. God love that system. Call of Duty 3. Again, they hadn't even got to Modern Warfare yet. Yeah. They were still just going by numbers. Genji, Days of the Blade, Madden, Marvel Ultimate Alliance. That was a good game. Need for Speed, Carbon, no. NBA, NHL. Resistance, Fall of Man. I prefer that game to Halo. That's just me. Ridge Racer 7, Tony Hawk's Project 8. Resistance, I regret to this day that I still haven't played Resistance 3. I love Resistance 1. It does not hold up very well in terms of first-person shooters. Resistance 2 is the better game. The story kind of goes off the... I like how it goes off the rails, and it's the guy that you're in control of. Are you ever going to play it?
Nah.
Nathan Hale is the main character you play as in Resistance 1. You're fighting... I don't remember if they're the Chimera or if that's Half-Life. I don't remember what the bad guys are called. You get infected by the aliens or whatever. You assume, like, every story, you get the virus, you get the antivirus or whatever, and you're fine.
Serum.
No, at the end of the game, you become them. Like, I think you still, from what I remember, it's been a long time, I think you still save the day, but then you become the alien. And I don't know, and Resistance 3, I think, just goes in a completely different direction. Like, they just leave Nathan Hale as an alien now or whatever, and you just completely abandon him, and you go on, like, a cross-country trip. Resistance 3, I think Colin says it's the best game, but it just for some reason the sales tanked after Resistance 2.
So what happens in 2?
That's what I just said. No, that Resistance 1, you fight the bad guys, you're as successful as you can be, whatever. You're still Nathan Hale in Resistance 2, but you're infected. You're fighting
it
off.
That was all in 1.
No, you're fighting it off throughout the game, then you get to the end of the game and you become one of them. At that time, that was like crazy that you would actually, you're going to become one of the bad guys.
Yeah.
Very underrated. That's a series I would love to see them bring back or reboot or something. Oh, God almighty. Avatar, The Last Airbender. Airbenders have no... I don't get it. How can you have Avatar with the blue cats running around and you got Avatar, The Last Airbender with the guy with the arrow and he's like... Whoa. No, nothing.
What are you asking?
How can there be two avatars? Two avatar properties.
Right.
IPs. I've never understood that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Call of Duty 3, Cars, Dragon Ball Z. Oh, yes. Remember this from back in the day. Budokai Tenkaichi 2. Twilight Princess.
Yeah.
That, write that down. Wii Sports, and Rayman Raving Rabbids. Did I say Rayman or Wayman? Rayman Raving Rabbids.
Wayman Waving Wabbits.
Honestly, I think I love Twilight Princess. It took me a long time to come around onto it. A lot of people hate that game. I think that's
stupid.
unfounded.
Yeah.
It's one of my top 75 games. It will be on the list.
Yeah.
Wii Sports to me is right now number two behind Super Mario World.
Really?
Think of the amount of, how many hours did you put into that game?
I know. We were just playing it with Daniel at Rec Room.
Like
10 years after it came out.
And I mean, that's what, the Wii is what really got my boys into games. Starting with Wii Sports. I can remember one New Year's Eve, we went over to Sarah and Terry's house and we just played Wii bowling and stuff all night and just got drunk and just played Wii Sports. Like, it was so much fun. Like, that game will live as long as you have a working Wii with a working sensor that your stupid cat doesn't bite through the freaking sensor wire. That game will live forever.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it. Shoot. In my eye. Oh, damn it. Shoot. And Twilight Princess, like I said, it gets a bad rap. All right, what do we got? I'm not going to count virtual console games. Those don't count on the Wii. All right, Wii U. Assassin's Creed 3, Arkham City, Armored Edition. Black Ops 2, way worse than Black Ops 1. Darksiders 2, Epic Mickey 2, Funky Barn. Okay. Mass Effect 3, Special Edition.
Was on Wii U.
Mm-hmm. New Super Mario U. I prefer New Super Mario Wii. I guess that wasn't a launch game. Well, yeah, because New Super Mario came out on 3DS before it came out to the
Right.
So that makes sense. Yeah. Nintendo Land, not as good as the other stuff. Tekken Tag, no. Wipeout 3, no. Zombie U, a lot of people like that game. I don't care about it. All right, PlayStation 4. All right, so we're getting down to the end here. All right. Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag, Battlefield 4, Call of Duty Goat, no. Flower, doesn't count. Killzone Shadowfall, nope. Knack, hell no. Rezogun. Rezogun, by far the best launch title on the PlayStation 4. Xbox One. Same stuff I mentioned. Killer Instinct. They brought Killer. I didn't realize that was a launch title. Wow. Rise. That game was horrible. That was their big first party game.
Rise, Lord Vader.
And the Switch.
Zelda.
Zelda. Again, but now technically, Shovel Knight is also a launch title. As is 1-2 Switch. Do we want to do the handhelds or are we good?
No.
Super Mario Land.
Yeah.
Tetris. Castle of Illusion. No Virtual Boy games will be mentioned.
I'm curious about 3DS.
They had a bad launch from what I remember people
talking
about.
They had like 3D World. Mario 3D World or Mario 3D Land. 3D Land,
was it really?
Called. I think that was
Game Boy Advance. Super Dodgeball. Super Mario Advance. Which one was that? Was that the first Advance? Was that Super Mario 1?
No, I think that was 3.
Okay.
I think.
Earthworm Jim?
On Game Boy Advance? Damn. I don't remember that.
Nokia N-Gage. I'm not going to engage with that discussion. Nintendo DS did have Super Mario 64 DS. Metroid Prime Hunters. Let's get PSP. Metal Gear Acid. No. Twisted Metal. Is there anything else? Come on. 3DS. Okay. Asphalt 3D. Bust a Move Universe, Combat of Giants, Dinosaurs 3D, Lego Star Wars 3, The Clone Wars, Madden, Nintendogs and Cats, French Bulldog and New Friends, Nintendogs and Cats, Golden Retriever and New Friends, Nintendogs and Cats, Toy Poodle and New Friends, Pilot Wings Resort, they keep doing Pilot Wings, Rayman 3D, Ridge Racer 3D, Super Monkey Ball 3D, Super Street Fighter 4 was a launch title. No, they did not. It did not launch with Super Mario Land.
That's terrible.
Virtual console doesn't count. The Vita, nobody cares because nobody cares. Poor Vita. Let's just see. U.S. Army Corps of Hell. Okay. Plants vs. Zombies, Ninja Gaiden Sigma Plus. Okay. Is there any real competition for Breath of the Wild? We read through a lot of really good games.
I starred the only ones that could be. Mario on NES. Mario 64. Oh, I didn't even star Mario World. All right, Mario on NES, Mario World, Super Nintendo. Mario 64, N64. Halo, Xbox. Zelda Twilight Princess on Wii.
Yep.
Wii Sports on Wii. And then Breath of the Wild. I think it comes down to these. I tell you right now, the only system I have two starred launch titles for is the Wii. Twilight and Wii Sports.
But wouldn't you prefer... It wasn't a launch title, obviously, but the GameCube version where you don't have to use motion controls.
Yeah, probably. I think... Now, I mean, I have Mario Brothers starred. That's more just... Nostalgia importance. And just, yeah, importance more than anything. And Wii Sports almost kind of falls into that same category. Like, it's fun, but you're not going to see, I don't know. I wouldn't consider that like a great game. Like, it almost doesn't even seem like a video game. It's just like a fun, like, activity. I don't know. But
by the way, Jess, when all this GameStop thing was going on that we talked about in episode 65, they're like, do you want to buy 1-2 Switch? And she's like, I don't think Kevin likes that game. No, I'd rather just take the gift card with the money on it. Thank you. Good job, buddy.
Yeah.
I'll get that used for $20 in a few months. We'll have fun with
it. So I would almost just get rid of Mario, get rid of Wii Sports.
Okay.
You're left with Mario World, Mario 64, Halo, Twilight Princess, and Breath of the Wild.
So right now, I mean, we're obviously prisoner of the moment now. Total hyperbole. We might feel
Breath of the Wild
6 months from now.
No matter what, is always going to be better than Twilight Princess.
Yes.
So you can get rid of that. Halo... A lot of people will say that's up there, but I think a lot of people will say that
Halo 2 is better.
Halo 2 is better. Three, like they all got better from there.
Yeah.
So, and obviously,
I get
if
it.
You've
we
been watching us, we're not first person shooters.
Well,
we're also not Xbox people. Like,
we
this game means nothing.
There would be no Xbox One or Xbox Scorpio coming if Halo didn't exist.
Correct.
So
it's another, like,
it's very
important.
Important, but
right.
I think so, there's only,
it's like Mario World, Mario 64, and Breath of the Wild. Nintendo, Nintendo, Nintendo. That wasn't by design, but...
Funny thing is, there's not a lot of good launch lineups.
Everybody well, no. I mean, everything...
craps on the Switch
the only
for
one,
having a horrible launch lineup. They
the
might
only,
have one of the best games ever made as
the
their
only
launch title.
The only starred game I have on here that's not Nintendo is Halo, and I don't even like that game.
I don't either.
Mario Brothers, Mario World, Mario 64, Zelda, Wii Sports, Breath of the Wild.
And Resogun.
So...
A lot of fun, but yeah. Breath of the Wild
it's
is
Breath
the best
the
launch
Wild.
Game ever.
It is, yeah.
I mean, as much as...
I mean, I think we kind of knew that going in. I don't think we were going to uncover a game that we
no.
forgot about, but it's not... There are not a lot of good...
No.
I mean, we went all the way back to 1977.
With a 2600.
40 years. 40 years, there are seven games that we thought were even worth mentioning.
And again, we're not counting Pac-Man, like... We're not talking importance. We're talking best
right.
game.
And again, that's pretty much the only reason Mario was on there. I mean, it's a good game, but that's more...
But it's not Mario World or Mario 3.
Right.
Or New Super Mario.
I'll leave Halo on there. Like, I don't care about it, but a lot of people just love that game. That's six games worth mentioning in the conversation over 40 years.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
It's Breath of the Wild.
It's Breath of the
Wild. It has to be.
Imagine if we get to the end and we beat it and, like, Link turns into Fee or Fi or whatever from, what's the Shadow...
Skyward Sword?
Yeah, that one with the S word. They were like, F this game, we choose Super Mario World.
yeah.
Where we're at right now, I mean, I think Mario World is the only one that's even in the discussion. I went back when we were in St. Louis, I had my, well, I brought my 3DS so Noah could play it because Nick was playing his... And while we were waiting for the kids to play asleep, I booted up my Super Mario World save. That game's difficult, too. Like, I was in the World 5, the Hidden Forest or whatever. It's not called the Lost Woods, but whatever it's called.
Basically the Lost Woods, yeah.
That is, it gets difficult.
With the bubbles.
Yeah.
With the
And you get the floating Mario, and you get the caterpillar things.
Yeah.
That game is so good, and it still holds up to this day. But yeah. I think it's far and away, though, Breath of the Wild is the best launch game of all time.
Yep. It has to be. Number two, yeah, it's probably Mario World.
It's got
to
be Mario World.
Number three,
64. Toss up or between Halo 64. Or this might piss people off, but I would probably say Twilight Princess.
Yeah. I don't know. But I think one and two is Breath of the Wild and Mario World. And then to me, it's
a big drop.
It's kind of a big gap, but it's like Breath of the Wild, Mario World,
and then everything else.
But I mean, there's a pretty big gap,
yeah,
even between those two. But
I agree.
Not a knock on Mario World by any means, but
Breath of the Wild is a once-in-a-generation game.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it. What do you guys think? Is Breath of the Wild the best launch game of all time? Is there any that we missed? Is there any that we glossed over that you think are the best? Again, we're saying best games, not most important games. I don't think Breath of the Wild is the most important game. You could probably say, if you went by that, it'd be Mario Brothers or Pac-Man. Probably.
Yeah.
Or even Space Invaders. Let us know your thoughts. Hit that comment section down below. Let us know what you think the best launch title of all time is. Is it Breath of the Wild or Are We Crazy? Again, thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, please hit that subscribe button. If you're watching us at youtube.com/2playerco-op, thank you. You know where else you should be watching us, though? Nerd901.com. Go to nerd901.com for all things nerdy in Memphis and around the world. Also, check out Pixels and Papers. They're one of our other podcasts that are there that are part of the Nerd 901 family. If you've seen our podcast before, great. If you haven't, that's also at youtube.com/2playerco-op. If you prefer audio podcasts, check us out at iTunes, SoundCloud, Stitcher, Google Podcasts, and audio services all around the world. You can reach out to us on Twitter. Let us know your feedback on the episode. I'm at KevinWhite24. He's at RealSeanWhite. Together, we're at 2player_co-op. Again, we got a Facebook page, and we don't update, so I'm not even going to mention that other than saying what I just mentioned. Again, thank you guys so much for being here. And until the next time, Sean, go ahead, take us out.
Thank you for playing.
Thank you.